Hi everyone, welcome to this video on creating a React app and configuring the React Speed Dial component. I will also show you how to integrate the Speed Dial button into another component and change its position, display mode, display direction, and a few other basic features. The React Speed Dial component is an extension of the floating action button. It displays multiple primary action buttons in linear and radial formats. To follow along with this video, make sure you have installed the latest version of React and Node in your system. I'll be using VS Code as my editor and show the output in the Chrome browser. First, I create a new application in VS Code using the command npx create React app and provide the app name, my React project. To create the React app with TypeScript, I add template TypeScript. It will only take a few seconds to create the project. I then navigate to the project location and install the Syncfusion Speed Dial button package using the command npm install syncfusion ej2 react buttons. Before using the Syncfusion components, I need to register the trial license key. I open the index.tsx file and import the register license method from the Syncfusion ej2 base package. Using this method, I register the React trial license key. From the 2022 Volume 1 release, the trial license key is mandatory for React products to avoid a licensing warning. To see where to generate a trial license key, check the description below. Then, I open the app.css file and replace the default styles with the Syncfusion Material CSS required for the button components. I open the app.tsx file and remove the default code snippets. In this video, instead of simply placing the speed dial button somewhere on the page, I'm going to place it in the bottom right corner of the DataGrid component and display the primary CRUD operations of grid when the button is clicked. First, I install the Syncfusion React Grids package using the command npm install @syncfusion ej2 React Grids. I include the grid component code with a data source. To learn more about integrating the DataGrid component into a React application, please check the Getting Started video linked in the card above and the description below. Now, let me run this application using the command npm start. As you can see, the DataGrid renders with the provided data source. Let's see the steps to add the speed dial button to the data grid. To start using the speed dial component, I import that component from the Syncfusion ej2 React buttons package and include the speed dial component tag. Then, to position this button over the data grid, I add an ID property to the data grid and assign it to the target property of the speed dial component. To display the grid settings icon in the button, I add the OpenIconCSS property. I'm going to use the predefined icon class eIconsEFieldSettings. In the app.css page, include the style reference for ej2 icons. To align the speed dial button over the data grid, I add the position relative style to the grid. Now I want to display three action items, add, edit, and delete in the speed dial component. So, I declare the variable action items of type speed dial item model and define the object with the fields, text, and icon CSS. Check here, I have imported speed dial item model from the buttons package. I assign this variable to the items property of the speed dial component. See, the speed dial is placed over the data grid at the bottom right corner. When I click it, primary action buttons are shown. You can customize the position of the speed dial to be anywhere on the target using the position property. The available options are top left, top center, top right, and so on. The default option is the bottom right. For now, I set the position to top right. And now the button is positioned in the top right corner of the grid. Notice here, the speed dial button action items are displayed based on the button position. You can change the display direction of the action items using the direction property. The supported directions are left, right, up, down, and auto. To display the action items on the left side, I add the direction property and set its value to the left. If you want to display the tooltip instead of text for the action button, then replace the text field name with the title in these items. Checking now, the action buttons are displayed on the left side, and the tooltip is displayed. Next, I will show you the built-in styles, primary, secondary, outline, and so on. By default, the primary style is applied. To apply the outline style, I add the CSS class property and assign the value eOutline. And now, the outline style is applied. Finally, I'm going to show you how to add a new record to the grid component when add item is clicked in the speed dial component. To edit the grid records, I import the edit service from the React Grids package and inject it into the grid services. Then declare the variable edit options and enable the allow adding property. I assign this variable to the edit settings property of the grid component. As I said earlier, I'm going to add the new record when add item is clicked. So, add the clicked event to the speed dial component and assign the callback method addGridRecord. I define this method here. To call the grid's built-in method, addRecord, I need to add the ref property in the DataGrid component. So, declare the variable grid object of type grid component. Then add the ref property to the grid component. Here, I call the addRecord method using the grid object. And I will change the button position to the bottom to explain the primary actions clearly. Now, when I click on this add action item, I can add a new row to the data grid. By default, speed dial items are displayed in linear mode, which means the action items are shown in a list-like format, either vertically or horizontally. To display the items in a circular pattern, I add the mode property and set its value to radial. Looking here, the action items are displayed in a circular pattern. You can refer to the documentation to see more customization options for the button and action items. In this video, I have shown you how to create and configure the Syncfusion React Speed Dial component using the Create React App command, and how to use a few of its basic features. You can download the working example of this from the GitHub link in the description below. I've also shared a link where you can learn about obtaining a free license key to use our React products if you're eligible for our community license. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel.